this little device has very few digital pins, and some people are looking for a way to add more digital pins into the Wemos device. Actually, all of the pins can be used as digital, but the website doesn't actually tell you how to use TX and RX pins as digital. These are the two pins that you can have in addition to other digital pins that you can connect and use them as normal digital ones. So this is what I'm going to show you today. Right now, the sketch that is uploaded is a simple blink example. And before I do anything else, I'm going to insert, just for the test purposes, two LEDs. One into the RX port. Let's make RX as red. And then one as TX. Let's make TX as green. Okay, so I assume the LED, the red LED, is already lit because this is an RX port and it's already supplying some current to it. So that's why it's already on. Let's look into the Arduino IDE and a simple example that I prepared to show you how to convert the TX and RX pins into digital pins. Okay.
In this article, you can find the reference table. You can use this reference table to assign a specific function to the pin that you need to use. For example, in our case, we need pin 1, which is TX, and pin 3, which is RX. If we want to use them as data pins, we would need to use them as GPIO 1 and 3, which is function 3. So we need to assign function 3 to both pin 1 and pin 3. The way to do this is to declare pin mode with the right pin numbers and then declare this as function 3 for both of them. And after this, of course, you need to define them as output because we're going to be using blinking LEDs. And this is a slightly modified example of the blink LED.
So let's now upload the sketch and see what happens. So when the sketch was uploading, you could see that both LEDs were lighting up. That is actually because the TX and RX ports I used during the upload process. And here you go. The TX and RX pins I used as digital output. Okay, so using TX and RX pins as digital output is fine. Using these pins as digital input is also possible, but you need to be aware that they are TX and RX pins, so you will not be able to use the serial port in order to communicate with the device. So you have to choose.
One other important thing is that if at some point in time in your program you need to reassign the TX and RX pins back to their original function, you would do the same. So you would do pin mode, LED red and LED green, and then you would state function 0 to set them back to TX and RX. Okay, so that's it. I hope it's been useful, and thanks a lot.